Hi and welcome! In a previous video, I presented the Serial Mouse Blaster, a project with the goal of converting a modern USB optical mouse to serial. As I mentioned in that video, there were a couple of issues. The main problem was that the board was too big, with bulky through-hole components, and it wouldn't fit nicely in a Microsoft Basic Optical Mouse version 2. A second problem was that if you unplugged the mouse, you had to wait for more than a minute until you could plug it in again. And finally, other modern mice that consumed a bit more than that Microsoft mouse wouldn't work. Well, I am very excited to announce that all three problems are now solved. The new revision of the board is SMD only, and also all its components are on a single side, which makes it much easier to assemble, inspect and debug. Also, the slow mouse reset was fixed, and now you only have to wait for around 5 seconds to plug in the mouse safely again. And finally, other modern optical mice, like the Logitech B100, work great! Okay, let's build it. I'm not great at soldering SMD components, but I find it easier to add a soldered blob on the PCB for one of the pins before attaching the component. Now, soldering the first pin is quite easy, you just need to melt the solder blob without adding any new solder. After the first pin is soldered, the component is usually secure, so we can solder the rest of the pins as usual. Soldering the wires directly on the board is a bit messy, but it will do for now. As you can see, the new board is very small and fits nicely inside the mouse. Let's try it out. It's not working. After a closer inspection, I found a couple of mistakes. First, I had used a resistor of the wrong value, 4.7K instead of 47K. So let's fix it. The second mistake was that I used 1 microfarad capacitors instead of 10 microfarad. Oh, and by the way, I replaced the solder wires with male headers and I attached DuPont connectors on the cables. This makes it less messy and more modular. And as you can see, once I power on the PC, the mouse lights up. And I'm not sure if it's very visible on the video, because it's very faint, but the Picos LED is blinking, which means that it works as expected. For now, I added a small component bag to avoid any shorts with the mouse circuit. And as you can see, it looks great. Okay, now let's try to load the cute mouse driver. As you can see, the mouse gets detected right away. Great! Now let's try a game to see whether it works well. And yeah, as you can see, the mouse works just fine. Now let's check mouse reset. As you can see, if I just wait for 5 seconds or so, the mouse just works. I managed to save a couple of milliamps by tuning the Picos firmware. It now consumes just over 6 milliamps. This change, along with the improved reset circuit, allows the board to work with the Logitech B100, which is currently the main mouse I'm using for testing. This revision of the board, revision 0.3, is now available on GitHub. I've also uploaded revision 0.4, which includes some small improvements over 0.3. If you happen to build one yourself, especially if you use a different mouse, feel free to share your experience. I'm trying to put together a database of compatible mice and the resistor values used for the LED mod, so any help would be greatly appreciated. Okay, that's all for now. I hope you enjoyed the video, and as always, thank you for watching and goodbye.